Complicite would like to invite you to listen to this audio description access flyer, which will introduce you to the cast and characters of their current production, Drive Your Plow Over the Bones of the Dead. Hello, I'm Jo, a petite white woman in her 40s, with brown eyes and ashy blonde hair cut into a bob with a fringe. My pronouns are she, her. Drive Your Plow Over the Bones of the Dead is a story told by a woman I admire greatly, a fiercely independent, quick-witted realist, an accomplished teacher, civil engineer, and environmentalist, Yanina Dusheko. Throughout Yanina's devoted investigations, I will be her ally, completely in step with her. Accompanying us through the events that unfold are nine actors who form a shape-shifting ensemble on stage. Cloaked in large black hooded puffer jackets, they're a shadowy presence, oscillating dark atoms, like a constant field of energy feeding the story with objects, such as teacups or books, and recreating memories and moments. When these black jackets are removed, the ensemble can become individual characters. Yanina's preferring not to use their given names, which often lack imagination. Her preference is epithets that come to mind of their own accord on first sight of a person. Like her neighbour, a very tall, wiry man with a long face, large ears, thick-rimmed spectacles, and an awkward demeanour. His clothes hang loosely from his frame, a wardrobe of clashing patterns. Pyjamas, a long, colourful, sleeveless, knitted waistcoat, tracksuit bottoms, short-sleeved shirt, and a boyish quilted anorak. His just receding hairline, protected by a trapper's hat, with the sides turned up. Oddball, for various reasons. Thesar Saracu plays Oddball.
My name is Thesar Saracu. I'm 64 years old. I am born in the Basque Country in Spain. I have brown hair and brown eyes. I'm 182 centimeters long.
Yanina's other neighbour, Bigfoot, perhaps named before she realised what a malevolent and unpredictable hobgoblin he was, always slightly drunk with greying hair which hangs thin and lank around his face. He wears a rancid stained vest and Y-fronts. Tim McMullen plays Bigfoot.
I'm Tim. I'm 60 years old. I'm white. I have brown curly hair. I have brown eyes. I'm male.
Tim also becomes Father Russell, a Catholic priest in traditional cassock and black beretta, the sort of clerical hat that looks like a fancy box of chocolates. He also becomes a gentleman with a poodle, a dog breed naturally grand and well-groomed, perhaps sharing this bond with his master, a man neatly dressed in a rich brown suit, jolly pocket handkerchief and black trilby. The dog's lead and harness are empty, yet animated by the gentleman, allowing our imaginations to match the poodle to the owner. The local police unit are regularly called upon, a keen young officer always first on the scene, in his police department baseball cap, impressive sideburns, thick rubber snow boots and huge black overcoat, his black coat. Here's Kieran Cabali-Dwyer who plays him.
Hello, my name is Kieran Cabali-Dwyer. My pronouns are he, him. I'm 25 years old, mixed race of Algerian and Jamaican descent. I am 6 foot tall, I have short afro hair and brown eyes.
Later, Kieran's voice will be distorted and deep to become inert, wealthily kitted out in a hunter's uniform of brown and green camouflage and night vision goggles, never without a rifle and a cartridge shoulder belt across his chest. In complete contrast, Kieran also becomes Dr. Ali, a softly spoken dermatologist in a regulation white hospital coat. A visitor to the area is Borosh, a heavy yet soft-footed man. He enters the story from the forest, dressed practically in a sand-coloured cardigan and multi-pocketed gilet, old walking boots, blue jeans and a checked shirt. His face is pleasant and bearded, with small spectacles perched on his nose. Not until he turns to the side do we discover he has a skinny little plaited pigtail of grey hair. Hannes Flashberger plays Borosh.
My name is Hannes. I'm 70 years old, I'm male. I have silver grey hair. I'm a little bald. And I'm Austrian.
A woman with an orthopedic neck brace is a part-time resident. She has an elegant, short, neat bob of ash grey hair, round silver glasses, plain grey knee-length dress, grey leggings and low-heeled grey court shoes, the writer, or as she appears to be covered in ash, the Grey Lady. Amanda Hadingay plays our Grey Lady.
Hello, I'm Amanda. I'm a white woman in my late 50s. I'm 5'6". I have light brown hair, sort of curly and cut in a short bob, and green eyes, and I'm she/her.
Amanda sits at an office desk in a leather jacket, moustache and wig to become the councilman, reminiscent of a young 70s-era Paul Newman. There's the police commandant, a barrel-bellied man accustomed to giving orders and being obeyed. He leads his team in a thick black military overcoat, shirt and tie and shiny peaked military officer's hat. Thomas Arnold plays him.
Hi, I'm Thomas Arnold. I'm 6'2". I'm white. I'm he, him. I have silver hair and dark brown eyes.
Thomas's other role, the president, is a slimmer, suited man with a moustache, his grey hair slicked into a side parting. His suit, tie, shirt and brogues all beige and vapid. Then there's a young friend and ex-student of Yanina's, Dionysi, Dizzy for short. He has a job in administration, so is smartly suited with a crisp white shirt, tie, polished shoes and a winter parka jacket. Dizzy's personality is better expressed by his tatty rucksack. He's an eternal student, carrying batteries of coloured pens, books and post-it notes wherever he goes. Alexander Uzoko plays Dizzy.
Hi, my name's Alexander Uzoko. My pronouns are he, him. I'm 6'1". I've got a slim fit build. I'm mixed race, white and black African. I've got short curly hair, fairly tight curls. I've got brown eyes.
A young woman held highly in Yanina's affections is good news. Her movement soft and her style angelic grunge. A dark velvet coat covers her sleeveless white flowing dress dipped at the hem in black and cinched at the waist with a studded belt. On her feet, chunky Doc Martin boots. She covers her head in an aquamarine wig. Veronica Maria plays Good News.
Hello, my name is Veronica Maria. I come from Poland, so I'm Polish. My pronoun is she, her. My height is 5.9, I would say. I'm quite tall, I must say. Some people compare me to a giraffe or like a slim, very tall tree. What else? I am white. My eyes are brown, and my hair are like kind of shoulder-length blonde hair.
We are introduced to two of the wives. Innard's wife, a relaxed redhead in a fur coat puffing on a cigarette, and the president's wife, a tense young woman, buttoned up in a geometric patterned knee-length dress, white tights and court shoes. With her hair curled and set and wearing a large white fur coat, she reminds us of a tremulous show dog. Here is Sophie Steer, who plays those characters.
Hi there, my name's Sophie Steer. My pronouns are she, her. My height is 5'9". I'm slight. My skin colour is white. I have brown mid-length hair and blue eyes.
And walking us through the landscape like a solitary she-wolf, Yanina, a name she neither likes or accepts. She dresses practically, black vest, checked shirt, purple tracksuit bottoms, battered trainers. Her hair is mid-length and grey. Yanina Dusheko is played by Catherine Hunter. Catherine is a small, slight white woman in her 60s with mid-length dark brown hair and bright, expressive, dark brown eyes.